Hello friends, welcome back to my channel, Happy Girl Alaska. I am your girl Terry, aka your Alaskan homegirl. And if you are new here, welcome. So today is Sunday, December. I don't know what number it is. I'm gonna say December 5th. But I am out and about doing some Christmas shopping and I wanted to check in with you all to see how you're doing today. I hope your weekend is going well. So this is actually twofold. What I wanted to do is kind of give you guys a brief summary of some of the recommendations that I made. People were asking me what is a really good time to visit Alaska. And after my last rant about winters and how I hate them, I don't want to deter anybody from visiting Alaska in the winter time. Visiting Alaska and living in Alaska, two different things. Okay, so keep that in mind. But what I want to do is share some of the recommendations that I have as far as when's the best time to visit Alaska. First off, I'll say that it depends on what you're into. That's very much going to play into your decision as to when to visit Alaska, because that is going to determine what things are going to be available to you to do. So let me go ahead and run through. I want to run through this as quickly as possible because I'm over here at Walmart. Y'all know how I feel about Walmart, but I know they probably have what I need at always low prices. So I'm gonna get in here, kind of stalling with this video. That's okay. All right, y'all. And the parking lot is packed. So you already know your girl is not feeling it, but whatever. Let's do this real quick. And then I'll go in and take care of my responsibilities. So, the first recommendation I would make is if you're into cruising, you'll probably want to try and get to Alaska. I would say the month of May is the best, because if you visit in May, you're going to beat what is referred to as peak season. In May, you won't have to deal with as many tourists. And I'm thinking that you may even be able to get a lower pricing on your cruise. Don't quote me on that. Do your research. And they have all types of different cruises you can choose from. You can do a day cruise. You can do maybe just like a couple hours. They have a 4 to 6 hour cruise. If you're interested to see what type of cruises are available, I have actually two videos out there, I want to say. I either have two cruise videos or one cruise video. I will include links down in the description box if you want to check it out. The cruises are breathtaking. They're absolutely gorgeous. And especially if you can catch it on a nice sunny day, you're gonna see wildlife and all that good stuff. Okay, and a real quick mention too is June and July are probably probably peak season for our cruises. One cruise company I would recommend, and I think it's more than just cruises, they do all types of like touristy type of stuff, is Kenai Fjord Tours. So look at them. They have so many different offerings. Check them out. If you decide to go on a cruise, let me know. I'd love to hear all about it. All right, so my next suggestion is if you are into fishing, then what you're going to want to do if you're interested in doing some classic fishing, aka combat fishing, is come during the month of months May through July. That is the optimal time for fishing. The king salmons are running during that time. Some popular fishing destinations and the type of fishing that people do. Ketchikan, if you're wanting to get some salmon. Homer, you'll want to go there for saltwater fishing. Ship Creek, which is actually located in downtown Anchorage. You can see the salmon. They're running, they're jumping up out of the water, and you will see people down there at Ship Creek elbow to elbow. So, I mean, if combat fishing is not your thing, you probably won't want to go to Fish Creek. But that is another option. Also, the Kenai River. If you're interested in catching some rainbow trout, you want to head over to Kenai River. And then there is Bristol Bay, and they are known for having huge salmon. And also, if you're wanting to get some kings, silvers, and chum, then you'll want to head over to Bristol Bay. If you want to do some ice fishing, which I think would be really cool, I've never done it, but I think it would be a neat experience. Anytime after October is optimal if you want to do some ice fishing. And so some locations for that, you can head over to the Kenai Peninsula, and people usually fish for cohos and burbot. And then if you want to head over to Fairbanks, then you can catch some trout, Arctic char, and Arctic grayling. So that's just some recommendations. If you're wanting to do some fishing, look at May through July for classic fishing, and then anytime after October for ice fishing. Okay, so if you are interested in going to visit some of the national parks are so popular here in Alaska. Peak season is normally July and August. That's when it starts getting pretty crowded, and some of our most well-known national parks are Denali National Park and Glacier Bay. A lot of people dream of visiting those national parks, but just be warned, if you come during July and August, it is going to be very busy. Now, if you're wanting to come during a time that is not as crowded and you want to take in the beautiful fall autumn scenery, which is one of my favorites, then you'll want to come and visit during early September. I believe they either, I don't know if they completely closed down the parks or what the deal is, but yeah, my notes here say come early September if you want to visit the parks, not have to deal with as many crowds. Okay, so you have some people that want to come to Alaska for another thing that Alaska is known for, and that is the snow. So especially people that you have who are into snowboarding, they're into skiing, maybe they want to get on a snowmobile, experience dog mushing. I would recommend going to Fairbanks if you want to have that experience with dog mushing, or maybe do snowshoeing, which my daughter and I are planning to do this year. You'll want to plan your visit somewhere around December through March if you really want to take advantage of the snow. November is a little too early because we don't get as much snow typically at the beginning of November, but definitely December through March would be the best time frames if you wanted to experience a real Alaskan winter, the type of winters that Alaska is known for. All right, so my next recommendation is if you are interested in seeing the Aurora Borealis, also known as the Northern Lights, then the best time for you to visit Alaska for that viewing would be the end of August to mid-April. And I mean the Northern Lights. I get asked about the Northern Lights, and I have to tell you, it is an amazing experience. I've seen them quite a few times, and every time I see them, I'm just in awe. I'm sitting there, and I'm just like, especially if you go and see them on a really clear night, and it's usually extremely cold when you do that, but it's worth it. And you can hear like the static, and then just watching them move. It's so eerie, but it's so cool at the same time. So again, if you wanted to see the Northern Lights, then plan your visit at the end of August to mid-April. Some of the best places to view for Northern Lights viewings, Fairbanks is one, Denali National Park. And the great thing about if you go to Denali National Park, you don't have to worry about the light pollution that you can oftentimes get if you're looking at the Northern Lights in a city. Now, what I will say is when I saw the Northern Lights, it has been here in Anchorage, but I had a really good viewing of them when I went out to South Anchorage in an area that didn't have as much housing. It was a perfect viewing area for that. Also Nome. So if you decide to go out to Nome, you can also, if you're wanting to check off that rural Alaskan experience off of your bucket list, then Nome would be the place to go. And then also Juneau. So Juneau, from fall to early spring, is a great time to view the Northern Lights. And from what I'm hearing is you can book a cruise that is geared for having their tourists or their visitors see the Northern Lights. So I think it would be really cool to experience that. I'm gonna look into that a little bit more because I wouldn't mind having that experience myself. All right, you all, so there you have it. You know, those are my recommendations as far as the best time to visit Alaska, as well as different activities you can participate in if you're visiting during those time frames. So I hope this video was helpful for you. If it was, please give it a thumbs up, comment, subscribe, share the video. Let's continue to join to grow this community. And I will see you in the next one. Take care. Bye.